main objectives of establishing water user associations in Tajikistan were maintaining, using, and operating irrigation systems in order to deliver on-time and adequate water supply to the water users. And another important objective behind establishing water user associations is managing conflicts among different water users. And the WUA, or Water User Association, is charged with the obligation dealing with conflicts through establishing ad hoc committees, and the decision of the committee of that commission, I would say, is then delivered to the special unit within WUA who implements the decision. The law on water user associations in Tajikistan was adopted in 2006, and with some amendments being implemented in 2011. Our analysis showed that only individual entrepreneurs and commercial entities or legal entities with a right to use lands can become WUA members, which leaves the kitchen gardens out of the scope of WUA law.
Kitchen gardens are really key. They're grown right next to the household, maybe in the household compound. It's a parcel of land that the household has decided to devote to the cultivation of fruits and vegetables that they're going to use for their own subsistence. They're going to consume them themselves, generally, different things like potatoes, carrots, tomatoes, all kind of the basic staples of daily life. And the significance of these plots has really grown over the last several decades because the price of some goods in the market has become too high for certain families to reach. And so kitchen gardens really help to mitigate the vulnerability of differences of prices of food goods in the market. And in particular, in rural areas, the major source of income is remittances from labor migration. This is an inconsistent and irregular source of income. And so having that kitchen garden there is really crucial to having a regular supply of diverse variety of fruits and vegetables. Kitchen gardens have become incredibly important for food security, and people are relying on them more and more. But at the same time, they still face challenges in cultivating these gardens. And one of those stems from a lack of access to water. Kitchen gardens rely on surface water irrigation, and they draw water from the same canal as dekhon farms, or private farms that I referenced before. And so they've also suffered from the same effects of deteriorated infrastructure that occurred after the fall of the Soviet Union, sometimes a lack of management capacity, and also difficulties in getting the right amount of water at the right time. And this can include a time that's convenient for households to access the water. For example, sometimes water arrives to kitchen gardens in the middle of the night, in which case it's difficult for women to be able to go out and access it at that time and make sure that it flows down the furrows of their kitchen garden and adequately waters all of their fruits and vegetables. And so as we think about moving forward and the potential of new local water management organizations like water user associations to improve the well-being of rural communities and ensure that they have adequate access to food, we need to be thinking about how these organizations can work with not only dekhon farms and these commercial private farms, but also kitchen gardens, as these are held, again, ubiquitously across southern Tajikistan. 99% of households rely on these.
But given that the law, the Water User Association law, doesn't explicitly address provision of water for kitchen gardens, and as a result, the village committees step in and kind of close the gaps in practice, even though they themselves are also not acknowledged explicitly as being the institution that provides water for kitchen gardens. So that's an important development that's kind of taken place to close the gaps in the law, in the Water User Association law.